One day a doctor dies by committing suicide. His training program replies, he passed away sleeping. The news, a doctor shames for just one honest mistake. Just how much shame can he take? After all, he's human. The public expects them to do their best, to act happy even when they are honestly suffering. When a doctor dies via suicide, patients lose a source of healthcare they really should not have lost. How many more doctors must die by suicide? They're overworked, anxious, depressed, and sleep-deprived. They have almost no time to care for themselves. Suck it up is what others around them yell. Why are these deaths often covered up or downplayed? Hiding the problem won't make it go away. To solve this huge problem, we must change the system. If you care, please listen to and act on this call for change. A doctor gets some help to improve her mental health. If her employers find out, they'll restrict her license. A doctor more time seeks to meet his patient's needs. Insurance companies tell him, just work faster. Medical students become resilient. They learn to show a facade of strength even when they need help. In the hospitals, they just might be told they're unimportant, 'cause they know so little. Must this be so? Medical schools might foster student enmity. Many students for the number one rank compete. If they fail board exams, they're told that they're screwed, but many persist because that's just not true. Why must doctors who seek help be so stigmatized? They might simply be trying to save their lives. The great stress that they bear might impede patient care. Let them get help. They're human just like anyone else. Most people who become physicians probably don't do so thinking they'll end their lives early because of their work environment. They start medical school wanting to learn about medicine to help others, but the training and work environment turns many of them into jaded, miserable doctors they never wanted to be. We must shed some light on the problem of physician suicide if we ever hope to solve it. If you want to know how big of a problem it is, just look at the statistics from the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. About 300 to 400 physicians die by suicide each year in the U.S. 28% of residents have a major depressive episode during training. The male physician suicide rate is 1.41 times that of the general male population. And the female physician suicide rate is 2.27 times that of the general female population. The system we have is killing physicians. We need to do something about it now. Doctors face pressure to see more and more patients in less time. Is productivity the best measure of good medicine? That pressure greatly disheartens doctors. It contributes to the doctor suicide epidemic. Doctors and their loved ones are at risk. How many more doctors must die by suicide? They're overworked, anxious, depressed, and sleep-deprived. They have almost no time to care for themselves. Suck it up is what others around them yell. Why are these deaths often covered up or downplayed? Hiding the problem won't make it go away. To solve this huge problem, we must change the system. If you care, please listen to and act on this call for change. If we don't address the root of this problem, we'll continue to lose large numbers of physicians to suicide, and the physician shortage will only get worse. Change needs to happen now.